Greetings, I am Chandrasekhar Nene, expert on international affairs. I am being assisted by Mr. Yogesh Kumbhar on the videography side. I would be very happy to welcome on the Maha MTB channel. Today we are going to talk about a very grave danger which has emerged out of Afghanistan, courtesy Al-Qaeda. 2 days back, on the anniversary, 20th anniversary of 9/11 attacks in New York, a video surfaced. The video is that of the old Al-Qaeda leader who was number 2 to Osama bin Laden. His name is Ayman al-Zawahiri. Ayman al-Zawahiri is an Egyptian terrorist who grew up in a quite a reasonably rich family in the southern suburbs of Cairo. The suburb's name is Mahdi. And he came into contact with the Muslim Brotherhood extremists, and slowly he joined Osama bin Laden in Afghanistan, and he became number 2 in Al-Qaeda. After Osama's killing done by the Americans in Abbottabad in Pakistan, he has been hiding. He's supposed to be somewhere in Afghanistan, somewhere in Pakistan. Nobody really knows for sure where he is. Last year, news had come that he's killed, or he's dead now due to old age. He's 70 years old, as I told you, but that was never confirmed. And this video, which has come to the world thanks to the research done by another good company in America called the Site Intelligence Group. This is a company currently headed by Executive Director Rita Katz. It is doing extremely good work by checking all the jihadi outputs coming on digital media or print media or wherever, collating the information, creating reports. And the clients for this company are actually various governments, various news channels and various other authorities interested in gathering intelligence which is available on public and private platforms. She has managed to, or this company has managed to get that video, 1 hour video it is, of the old man. In that video, he has definitely mentioned something of an attack on the Russian army base in Syria, which was, the attack was attributed to Al-Qaeda, and he has congratulated Al-Qaeda for that. That attack took place on the 1st of January this month. That means this person was definitely alive till 1st of January. Since he doesn't mention explicitly the retreat of American army and NATO army from Kabul, it is doubtful whether this video is made after the retreat, which is says it is doubtful whether the person is still alive or not. But that is of no importance. What is important is that this person is exhorting his followers and other people who are sympathetic to Al-Qaeda to continue the struggle. He is congratulated that, 20 years have passed and we have done this, and we have done this great job of killing 3,000 Americans and destroying America's reputation and the World Trade Center towers on 9/11/2001. So this is what America was expressly saying, that we have finished. They said Al-Qaeda is no more in Afghanistan. But he specifically says here that actually speaking, Al-Qaeda is the one which has spawned Taliban. Taliban is doing the handiwork of Al-Qaeda. So he has taken credit of everything which is happening thanks to Taliban to Al-Qaeda. So which is in direct opposition to what President Biden was saying when he was hastily running away from Kabul, which is very odd to say the least. This is also a slap on the people who are pro-Taliban people, who are Taliban sympathizers, Taliban apologists in our country, in external countries, who kept telling us that, no, this is a new Taliban. This is not the cruel Taliban which didn't want to be friends with anybody in the world. This is a new Taliban which wants to engage with the world. These people were living in Doha, in five-star hotels. They are sophisticated. They are not cruel to women. They are not even going to be very cruel to non-Pashtuns in Afghanistan, because Taliban is a completely Pashtun outfit. But look what happened. This is what they kept on parroting on the various interviews when they were in Doha, Qatar. Once they have got power in Afghanistan, look what they are doing. None of their ministers is a non-Pashtun. It's all Pashtun kind of conglomeration. They are completely not sympathetic to women. Not only that, they have started flogging women in public. We have seen lots and lots of videos to that effect. Because unfortunately for Taliban, this is an age of social media. So their cruelties cannot be remaining hidden. They have been known to cut fingers off the ladies who had nail paint, nail polish done on their nails, on the hand nails and things like that. They have been the same Taliban in a new bottle. And the bottles is also wearing out very fast, and their cruel face is coming in front of the people, in front of the world. Now, when this video was being promulgated, in the video he has made two mentions which are concerning, one is concerning the world, one is concerning us. He has said that it is his aim, it is the aim of Al-Qaeda. Incidentally, Al-Qaeda means the base. Qaeda in Arabic is the base. So, this is a base of all the global jihadists, that's what they claim themselves. He says, one of the aims of Al-Qaeda is to rid Jerusalem of all the Jews. What actually is meaning is finish Israel, finish all the Jews in Israel, and that is one of his aims. A second aim, he has very casually mentioned that Kashmir needs to be cleared. What does it mean? In India, we know very well what it means. In 1990, we have seen what Kashmir clearance meant, when all the Kashmiri Pandits were literally thrown out of their homes and they had to come into Indian side of non-Kashmiri side of India, and they had to be put in refugee camps. They are still living in refugee camps in Delhi. It's actually a shame on Indian people that our brothers are still living in refugee camps who have been kicked out from Kashmir. Thankfully, with the new Narendra Modi government, efforts are being made to resettle them back in Kashmir and all that. But here is what Al-Qaeda is saying. And you know what Taliban said to our people in Doha when they went and met them? That Taliban is not interested in Kashmir, they are only interested in securing Afghanistan. Even at that time when I did a couple of videos, I had mentioned that you cannot trust these Taliban people. This is exactly what is being done. The person who promised us at that time, his name was Mullah Baradar, who is the Deputy Prime Minister of Afghanistan, but who is of the Taliban faction, which is anti-Pakistan faction. So when ISI Chief General Faiz Hamid went to Kabul for the swearing-in ceremony, they kind of ensured that the Haqqani network, which is the Taliban faction of Pakistani, pro-Pakistan faction, will get most of the important portfolio in the ministry. And rightly so, what they did, the interior minister is Sirajuddin Haqqani, who carries a bounty of $25 million on his head from the FBI. We should simply write an email to FBI telling them that we know where he is, this is where he is, please give me my $25 million. It is as idiotic as that whole thing, that the person on whom the bounty is riding from America is currently heading internal security for Afghanistan Taliban people. And these are the Taliban with whom American government made deals. They made the deal with Taliban to secure Afghanistan for them and leave Afghanistan and blah blah. They made deal with the people who actually killed 3,000 Americans on the 9/11 and who had been killing them. Because even in Ayman al-Zawahiri's admissions in 2019, three US Marines who had worked in Afghanistan earlier were murdered in Pensacola, Florida. And the murder was done at the insistence of Al-Qaeda by some jihadist killers in America. So this is the face of Taliban, this is the face of Al-Qaeda, with whom America is making deals. I mean, shame on that country. I don't know how that people and citizens of America are tolerating that country. But for us, the real worry is that they will soon, once they get their own internal affairs in order, once they kill every non-Pathan in the government and outside the government, they will definitely turn their attention towards India. Because that's what Pakistan has been telling them all along. Some news leader in Pakistan had even mentioned that now Taliban will liberate Kashmir for us. Pakistani army is so useless, they cannot do their own job. All they can do is outsource their job, this time to Taliban. Indian army is not useless. Indian army is very secure. We have got security arrangements in Kashmir and all that. But look at whom these people are. And look at the United Nations, what they are doing. They are gathering $1 billion to support these the people in Afghanistan. You know, if there is a blood cancer and the blood is in short supply, then the patient would be given blood transfusion. Unfortunately, the transfused blood actually goes to the cancerous cells. This is exactly what will happen to the $1 billion if United Nations give them as a relief in Afghanistan. All that money will actually go to Taliban and Taliban sympathizers. Don't the world leaders realize this? We should never be party to any such effort to aid Afghanistan at this moment. Let Afghanistan clean themselves of this Taliban junk, which in Panjshir is being currently done. All the countries all the countries should help Panjshir to secure their own land and then liberate Afghanistan from this Taliban clutches. A look at American situation here is very clear from what Anthony Blinken, when he testified in front of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee yesterday. Senate Foreign Relations Committee is a very powerful committee, and they are asking him about the retreat from Afghanistan. How did America fail? And he says about the role of Pakistan, he says, you see, Pakistan was partly with us, partly with the Taliban people. And why? Because India's actions in Afghanistan forced them to do so. What are India's actions in Afghanistan? We were actually helping the Afghan people by building their parliament, by building schools, by building hospitals, by building a dam, Salma Dam, to give them electricity and all that. These activities incited Pakistan to help Taliban against US. This is what the Secretary of State of US is saying. I think there needs to be some rethink in the whole US establishment, and our foreign relation, our foreign affairs department should do this, pro-haste, should do and educate the American people that what you are, again you are doing the same mistake by giving apology to Taliban, apology to Pakistan. What is said that Pakistan should line up is the word, with the international community, so that international community can then start dealing with Taliban. Is that your priority? I don't know really. These are very ominous circumstances. India should be very careful. We should be on guard all the time. And let us hope that the situation resolves quickly and Afghanistan gets rid of Taliban, and Taliban again actually gets finished for good this time, so that the threat to our internal security also disappears. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please circulate it among your friends and relations. And please subscribe to our channel. If you press the bell icon, our new videos will be instantly given as an intimation to you. Thank you.